Hey, what's up, guys? Set 3 is coming out very soon in English, so I'm trying my best to cover as much gold pattern stuff that's included in it before its release. As always, I wrote an article on the subject matter, so if you're interested in a more detailed version of what I'm about to talk about, I'll drop the link in the description box below. So, although Raven Azul seem like the more popular build right now, let's not forget that our boy Garmor is featured in the new set as well. His first skill is pretty bad, but his second skill is good enough to justify building a deck around him. That's what Tseng Qi, the Hong Kong representative, did at Worlds. He brought a really interesting Garmor deck at the biggest Vanguard competition and went 3-1 in Swiss, which, all things considered, is pretty good for a quote-unquote budget deck. The deck has a really simple primary winning condition: swarm the field with the top deck's superior calling abilities, give power to those units, and then beat down the opponent. Garmor pretty much has all these components in a single ability. His Unride plus 3k power helps a lot of units in the deck like Sagramor, Maxlash, and even himself reach really key numbers to not get stopped by defensive triggers, especially against force decks. As for his superior call ability, it's the usual Gold Paladin top 3 superior call effect, which not only helps swarm the field, but also helps set up the secondary win condition of the deck, which is stacking triggers at the bottom of the deck. Yep, you heard me right. Combined with Vivian and Azirus, the deck can stack triggers at the bottom of the deck at a rapid pace. That matters because if the primary goal of beating the opponent down fails, the deck can rely on revealing multiple triggers near the end of the game, Tsukuyomi style. This is achievable by not running any units that shuffles the deck, like, for example, Bowmains, by, of course, playing multiple copies of Vivian and Azirus, and also by running a good draw engine to speed everything up. Although Gold Paladins are not OTT when it comes to pure draw power, the clan still has its own way to draw and speed through the deck. For example, Hoggin can superior call from the top of the deck, Sagramor and Blennius mix through draw and call, and Dindrain can net us a draw after being called by an ability. All of these combined with an above average amount of draw triggers makes it so that the deck has enough card advantage to defense against opposing assaults and good enough speed to reach its stack in time. And yeah, at least when it comes to Garmor's overall strategy, that's pretty much it. Gold Paladin won't be receiving any support for a little while after this set, so it's really nice to have a different and interesting variant in the same clan. Whether it's Pelennor or Garmor, I'd advise anyone that have the possibility to try those decks out to do so, as they are a refreshing take on V-Series Gold Paladin. Anyway, that's it for me today, guys. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.